Okay guys, so today we'll learn about eval function in ESQL. So let's get started. So this eval takes one parameter in the form of a string, and that parameter is a ESQL expression. So if you see the syntax, inside eval we write a ESQL expression in the form of a string. If you see this example here, I am passing an expression a plus b. I am encapsulating this expression in single quotes so that it represents a string. So eval takes expression in the form of a string, and that expression is a ESQL expression. So what I am doing here, inside a variable result, I am storing the outcome of a plus b. Suppose a is 2, b is 3, then outcome of a plus b of 5 will be stored in my result. So if you notice this thing and this thing here, inside eval I'm just passing a part of ESQL expression, right? If you see that, I'm only passing a plus b, but here I'm passing the whole ESQL expression. See, starting from s till semicolon, I'm passing everything, right? Starting from s till semicolon. So eval can be used with part of ESQL expression, or it can be used with complete ESQL statement. Now the question is, why do we use it, right? See, if I simply write result is equal to a plus b, my outcome is same, right? Result is equal to 5. Then why do we use eval? So eval means, the significance of eval is that, if you see the last statement, eval, real power of eval is that it allows us to dynamically construct ESQL expressions or statement. See, the moment you see this word dynamically, it means that at runtime you are deciding the fate of ESQL expressions, right? At runtime you are changing something based on some condition from input. See, if you don't understand any of this thing which is written over here, no worries at all. We are going to see a practical example so that you will understand. I will try to make the example as simple as possible so that you can easily understand it. Plus, I'll implement a scenario first without eval and then with eval so that you can easily feel the difference. So let's quickly get started. So let me quickly create an application. Name this application like I'm giving it as eval app. Finish it. New message flow. Give it any name. Give any name to schema. Finish it. Okay, let's make it a web service. HTTP input. Reply. For transformation, let's take this. Compute. Okay. Give an endpoint, I'm giving it as POC. Select JSON. Input will be a JSON, a simple JSON. Okay. Let's get rid of this unwanted code. Now, let's go ahead and understand the requirement which we are going to implement. See, this is a very simple JSON message which I will be receiving as an input, right? So it contains two numbers and mathematical operation that has to be performed over these numbers. See, if it is plus, then we have to add these two numbers. If it is minus, we have to subtract. If this is multiplication, we have to multiply. Accordingly, based on this thing, we have to decide what we are going to do with these two numbers, right? What operations we are going to perform over these. Okay, so first implement this without eval. So let me quickly write a code here. Let me declare a reference, declare input reference, reference to input root dot json dot data dot root. See, we have a root tag, right? Till that we have taken a reference. Now declare a character, operation care, we are taking the value of operation. What is that? This thing, right? Now this operation will store the plus minus, I mean this will store the operation plus minus multiplication, right? And we'll check what is my operation and accordingly we'll perform that operation, right? So if operation is equal to plus, then set output root json dot data dot root dot result, right? In this particular tree I'm setting the result of a plus b. In ref dot right, let me copy this thing. Let me make them else if. Let's change it minus multiplication division division multiplication, right? So now I'm achieving my result like this. If it is plus, then I'm adding. In ref we have two numbers, number one and number two. In ref I'm adding those two numbers. If it is minus, then I'm subtracting. Accordingly I'm doing the things outright. So let's go ahead and run this, I mean deploy this. Deployment was unsuccessful. Why? Okay, let me close it. So there was some problem, so let me deploy it again. It is deployed now. Let me copy my input. Let me take it to here. Paste it. The endpoint I have given is POC on my HTTP input node. Okay, now execute it and let's see the result. See, there are two numbers, 4 and 2. Result of multiplication is, if this is plus 6, if this is minus, result should be 2. If this is division, again result should be 2. So I have implemented my requirement. Now this is without using eval. See, if I use eval, then I can pass this whole thing as a string inside eval. If I do that, then I mean we can get rid of this multiple lines of code and this multiple if else ladder, right? So let me just comment this thing. Comment. Go ahead. Write this line. Eval. Now this should be a string, okay? So now we have basically we have an operation, right? So we have to break these strings. Like, see, this is one string, right? Concatenate operation in it. I mean, this whole thing should be a string, right? I'm just making it a string. I'm not doing any rocket science here. Okay. This expression is same as this thing. Just I have made it as a string because eval expects a parameter as a string. Save it. Deploy it. Deploy it again. Execute. Again, result is same, right? Multiply 14. Suppose I'm changing anything, right? So I'm getting my outcome as same as I was getting with this code, but here I am writing only one line of code and I am achieving my result, right? So dynamically at runtime I am deciding my operation, and by making use of eval I am deciding the fate of this outcome, this ASQL expression, and achieving my outcome, right? So this is the real power of eval. At runtime dynamically we can decide what we can do based on some condition from input. Right, so what is the condition from input here? This operation, right? So I am getting this condition from input, and based on that I am making use of eval to achieve my outcome, and this is only a one line of code, right? So this way also I can achieve my result using eval. So this is all about eval, but in this tutorial I want to tell you one more scenario which actually in an interview interviewer asked me. He asked me like, there are two procedures, right? The questions, pay attention to the question first. There are two procedures. Both the procedures are there in different schema, right? But name of both the procedures is same. Suppose there is a procedure called employee, right? This procedure is residing in one schema. Also, the procedure with same name is residing in different schema. Both the procedures have different purpose, but name is same and they are in different schema. How can we invoke them dynamically at runtime? So the answer was eval, that using eval we can dynamically invoke the function at runtime. We can decide which procedure we want to call, right? So how we can do it, we are going to see a practical example. Okay, so in order to save time, I have already created the application, right? So let's understand the requirement. See, we have this input which we will be receiving, and based on this thing we will be invoking the procedure. So let's understand how. This input will contain this tag, professional details. Sometimes it will contain personal details, right? So I have created two procedures. Procedure name is EMP details, and both the procedures are there in different schema. It is in this schema, eval.personal.employee, and it is in eval.professional.employee, right? So if this tag name is personal detail, then it will provide me the personal details of this employee, right? So it will call this procedure which is there inside this schema, which will give me the personal details of this employee. If this tag name is professional detail, now it is giving me the professional details of this employee. So for professional details, we have this procedure in different schema. So this is giving me the professional details of this employee, right? So here, see, we are seeing that there is a procedure. Procedure name is same, expecting the same parameters, employee ID, an output reference where my output result will be stored. DB record, I mean, I'm fetching the results from the database, right? Based on the employee ID, I'm fetching the results from the database, right? And those results I'm mapping from the database inside my output route, right? So it's simple. So I'm at runtime, I am deciding which procedure I'm going to call, right? Based on some condition. And what is that condition? This thing. If this tag name will be professional details, then I will go ahead and call this procedure under this. If my tag name is personal details, then I will go ahead and call this procedure under this. So dynamically at runtime, I have to decide which procedure is to be called. So this is my flow. Under that, I have provided a code, right? So I mean, this is a very simple code. Here, see, I'm calling the procedure at runtime. After getting all the details, I am calling this procedure. So let's understand this code one by line by line. See, there is a character which I have declared. This character will store this thing, right? Because this is variable. This can be personal details also, this can be professional details also. This is variable, so for that I have declared this first child name, and under that, using a field name function, I am storing this field name, right? Schema name, I am storing this schema inside this character, either this schema or this schema based on the condition, right? Employee ID, in input I have an employee ID. I am storing this employee ID. Why? Because based on this employee ID, I am making call to the database, right? Where my employee ID is this. So this employee details is nothing but it is storing results from the database, right? And this DB record is nothing but it's a reference till the records which I am getting from the database, and this DB record I am passing inside my procedure, and right, so this procedure also expects my DB results, database results. Okay, so this is I am creating output in which I have to send the result and display it to user, right? This tag name is the variable, so I am passing it into a curly braces. See, if you want to know more about it, like how can we pass a variable inside my root, so you can go back and watch my video, like interview question number 10, where I have explained a scenario and I have explained all these things, right? So you can go back and watch that video. Now here I'm checking if my first child name I am storing this. If this name is professional details, then I'm setting my schema name as this thing, right? And if it is personal details, then I will store my schema name as this thing, right? So here I'm making use of my input condition. Okay, now inside eval, I'm writing this call statement. What is this statement? See, call, how we call a procedure which is present in a different schema. You can go back and watch my previous video, interview question number 11, in which I explained the same thing, how we can achieve this call. Then we write schema name, then dot procedure name, right? So I am doing the same thing here. Call, schema name, dot procedure name, and this procedure expects three parameters, right? So I have to pass these three parameters inside this, right? Employee details, output, and DB records. Employee ID, output, and DB records, right? So this, as a whole, this is representing a complete ESQL expression. This call, schema name dot procedure name. So this whole thing as a string, I am passing inside call, inside eval, right? So by doing this, I am dynamically deciding based on this condition. I am dynamically deciding which procedure I am going to call, right? This schema name is variable. If this is professional, then my schema name will be this thing. Then schema name dot my procedure name, and this procedure will be called, which is there in this schema. If I'm getting personal details in input, then different procedure will be called, right? So without eval also we can achieve this. Let me comment this, and let me comment this also. These two things, directly write call, schema name, this thing, dot my procedure name, right? This is also a way. But here, if you notice, I have to write this call statement two times. This is personal, right? Here I am writing this call statement two times. So in order to avoid that, I am making use of eval, so that with a single call statement I can achieve my results. Okay, also you must be thinking, like, can't we give like schema name? See, I have already stored my schema in a variable, so can't we do this? No, we can't do this. See, it will give me error, right? Here we cannot pass a variable name. We can't pass it, even if I use curly braces like I used here, right? I can't do it. See, I saved it again. Error is there. Here I can't pass variable name, so I am left with only one option, eval. Eval expects a string, so we can manipulate it the way we want. Here, call schema name dot my procedure name, and accordingly I will get my results. So let me deploy it. This is deployed. Let's go ahead and run this. Now I want to get professional details of this employee. See, this employee is there in a database, this thing, right? So I will be getting professional details by doing so. See, if I change it to personal, see, now I'm getting personal details like address, date of birth, phone number, right? So at runtime, based on this condition, I'm deciding which procedure is to be called, and accordingly I'm getting my results, right? So this is all about EVAl, and now I have explained you two practical examples, so I believe now you very well understand what is EVAl and what is its significance. I also recommend you to go ahead on web IBM website and read about EVAl more, right? So thanks guys for watching this video.